Today we're going to talk about issuing bonds at either a discount, and then we're going to issue bonds at a premium in a later video. Now this particular video does not discuss the conceptual support for why we are issuing bonds at a discount or premium. That's going to be in a different video. It's simply going to show you the mechanics of how we go about issuing bonds at a discount. Now here's the data we're going to work with. And we're going to be amortizing the bonds using the straight line method. We're going to issue $20 million of face value bonds at a contract rate of 8%, and these bonds will mature in 5 years. Now, the bond market, interest rates fluctuate by the minute. So whenever you issue bonds, you're never going to issue them where the contract rate and the market rate are identical. They're always going to be off by a little bit, which means we issue a bond at a discount or a premium. Now, a shortcut to calculating bond values is to say bonds were issued at 97% of face value or 98% of face value. Now, what that is telling us is that since we're issuing the bonds at 97% of face value, we're not going to receive face value for the bonds. And the reason for that is that the market rate is higher than the contract rate on the date of issuance. So we have to accept less money than the face value that we're going to eventually have to pay back when the bonds mature. Okay, so if we issue bonds at 97% of face value, then what that means is we're going to raise $19.4 million cash. So on the day that we issue the bonds, we're going to debit cash for $19,400,000. Now we always credit bonds payable, I'm going to abbreviate BP, bonds payable at face value. And that means that we're going to have an unamortized bond discount of $600,000. So I put a lot of stuff on the board here. Let me walk you through it. First of all, from a T account standpoint, bonds payable is a liability. We're borrowing money. We're going to credit bonds payable at face value. And notice that the unamortized bond discount, I put discount here, but it's really the unamortized bond discount, we debit for $600,000. Use T accounts here because it gives you a good visual and it'll help you in terms of amortizing the bond. Now, look at the chart up here, okay? Over 5 years, on the date of issuance, we only generated $19.4 million, and again, it's because the market rate was higher than the rate, the contract rate, which is what we're paying. As we amortize the bond, the book value, which is bonds payable minus the unamortized discount, which is, and this is the amount we have to report on the balance sheet, is going to increase until the bond discount is fully amortized. And on the maturation date or date of maturity, we're going to pay back the bondholders $20 million. So we receive $19.4 million, but we have to pay back $20 million. So we have to pay back $600,000 more than we received. Rather than expense that $600,000 in year one or at the end of year five, we're going to amortize it, which is the same as depreciation. We're going to spread it out and allocate it over the 5 years that we benefit from the bonds. Now, using straight line amortization, we take our discount of $600,000, we divide it by 5 years, and we're going to amortize $120,000 per year. Now, on December 31st, let's just say we issued the bonds on January 1st to keep life simple. On December 31st, if that's when we pay interest or if we accrue interest, either way, then what we're going to do is 20 million times 8%, my interest payment is going to be 1.6 million. So I'm going to credit cash 1 million. $600,000. Now, I'm going to amortize the bond 1/5 for each year. So I'm going to credit the discount for $120,000. So I'll put bond discount. I'm just going to put discount here. $120,000. And I'm going to debit interest expense for $1,720,000. Okay? And so that extra $600,000 that we have to pay back, we allocate it over 5 years. And each year, we increase the interest expense that we report on the income statement by $120,000. Now, on the balance sheet, we have to report bonds at book value, which is the face value minus the unamortized discount. Now, at the end of year one, we've amortized 1 year's worth of interest, and that's what a bond discount represents, deferred interest. And so now, 20 million minus 480,000, okay, our book value will be 19,520,000, okay, which is 20 million minus the 480. Okay, and so on the date of issuance, here's our journal entry. If we issue the bonds at 97% of face value, and if it's any other number, you simply multiply that by the face value. Here's the amount of cash proceeds. Here's the discount. We always credit bonds payable at face value. And when we pay interest, which could be, it's normally semi-annually, twice a year. But in this case, for simplicity, we just use annual. I'm going to pay $1.6 million. I amortize 1 year's worth of the discount, $120,000. And that will increase my interest expense that I report on the income statement to $1,720,000. Okay, and if we look at the bottom of the board here, notice, if the contract rate and the market rate were identical, the same, there would be no discount or premium. We would issue the bonds at $20 million, the face value. When the contract rate is greater than the market rate, we issue bonds at a premium. And in this case, when the contract rate is less than the market rate. Now, we don't know specifically what the market rate is because we're taking a shortcut, but we know it's more than 8%. We have to issue the bonds at a discount. And that's because investors know that they can get a better return, a higher interest rate, if they invest elsewhere. So what we do is we compensate for the difference in interest rates by reducing the price of our bonds so that we are effectively paying whatever the market rate was on the day that we issue bonds. Okay, and that's how we issue bonds and amortize them using the straight line amortization method.